Hi guys, how are you doing? Hope you're well. Today I am doing a wear test and I am trying out a new foundation by Barry M. I was actually asked to try this out, so I thought I would. It's the All Night Long Full Coverage Foundation. I have used this one before and I have a couple of thoughts on it, so I thought I would share with you my thoughts on camera. If you like wear test videos, then don't forget to give me a thumbs up and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And yeah, let's talk down below. So, today, as I mentioned, I'm going to be reviewing this particular foundation. It's supposed to be a full coverage foundation, and it says on the back here that all night long foundation will have you covered until the early hours with its smooth, creamy formulation, which is easy to blend and feels lightweight on the skin with moisturizing vitamin E and antioxidizing fruit extracts for a healthy look that's yours. This foundation that I picked up is in the shade Chestnut. I don't know if it's a bit too dark for me, but we shall make it work. And also, bearing in mind, guys, when I put foundation on sometimes, unless it's like completely not my shade, my exposure sometimes makes it look slightly lighter on camera. So I'm still trying to work out my settings here. And also, I have got a primer on as well. So just so you know why my skin is doing this. So I'm going to quickly just pull up the foundation on my phone. The foundation comes in 15 shades, as you can see right there on my phone. I believe it comes with a white shade right there. And if I click on this, I think the darkest shade, I can't really tell. The darkest shade they do is that one right there, which is Chestnut. I was actually debating between this shade here, which is called Pecan, and the shade I actually bought, but I ended up getting the Chestnut shade. I am going to do a wear test. I'm going to put on the foundation. You can see how it applies, tell you my thoughts about the initial application, and then I will also give you an update as to how the foundation wore throughout the day at the end of the day. I've already done my skin prep, so I have used my Primark PS Pure Priming Glow Essence, which I love, and I also used my Becca Primer, which I also love, on top of that. And yeah, let's get into it. So I'm just going to shake up the foundation. It comes in a plastic bottle as such, and you can see right there that it comes with a pump, and I have actually used this foundation, as I mentioned before. And as you pump, you can also see that it will kind of go up in the bottle, so that's quite good because you can see how much you're actually using. The foundation itself comes with 30 mils, which is a standard bottle, and I think it retails for £7.99 in store. I picked mine up from Superdrugs, and it also has a shelf life of 12 months as well. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to pump it directly onto my face because that's what I like to do with foundation. And you can see the color that it gives. From what I can recall with this particular foundation, I didn't find that it necessarily oxidized on me, but you can see that the shade Chestnut is slightly red for me, has a slightly red undertone. I don't know if you can tell on camera because of the exposure, but you can kind of see it. It's not a terrible match. It blends out really, really well, and as you can see, that one pump didn't really do the full half of my face because it's kind of finished now. So I definitely think I need about three pumps for my full face. It has quite a chemical scent to it, which I'm not the biggest fan of because sometimes scents can make my eyes water, and yeah, it's not going to be great for me. And yeah, the scent on this one is a bit strong, but once you've blended it in, I find that you don't really smell it as much anymore. Now, as I'm blending this, I can definitely feel that it's a matte foundation. It dries very quickly, so you do need to work quite fast. I think it is quite buildable, but I'm not going to build it up because I just want to wear it as I would typically wear my foundations, and I don't tend to go beyond three pumps with a medium to full coverage foundation. But I think that it looks quite nice on the skin. If you guys can see, it's covered quite well. I do have like pigmentation under my eyes, hyperpigmentation, and I think it's covered it reasonably well. It hasn't got rid of it, and I think that this looks more like a medium coverage to full coverage. as opposed to a proper full coverage foundation like they claim. So if you want a, you know, a really, really full coverage foundation, then I think you'd have to build this particular one up. On my skin, it has actually dried down. If you've got dry skin and you wanted to wear this, I feel like you wouldn't need to put on the powder because it is quite dry on the face. Slight tackiness, as in if I felt comfortable not wearing powder, I think I would be someone that probably wouldn't. But with this foundation, because it can be, it does feel a bit drying initially on the skin. So those are my initial thoughts of when I just applied it. So we're going to apply products on top of it and we're going to see how products go on top of it. Now I am actually using the All Night Long Full Coverage Concealer from Barry M as well, because I thought, you know, if we're using the foundation, we might as well use the concealer in the same range. So this is what the concealer looks like. The shade that I've got is Hazelnut. I think this was the darkest shade I saw, but I might be wrong. I know Collection extended their shade ranges, but I'm not too sure on whether Barry M did a further extension, because I know they did initially. But anyway, this is the shade I've got, Hazelnut. I have used this concealer quite a bit. I do quite like it. It does last quite a while. I think we're just being spoilt with the wand sizes nowadays, you know, where everyone's bringing out a thicker wand. So these thin ones are not my favorite anymore, to be honest. I find that they can be quite, like, they can stab out, like I just did there. Like, it can be quite scratchy on the skin. Don't really like the wand, but it is a very small bottle, as you can see. You get 5 mils in this, so it is a small concealer, but nevertheless, it's still quite a nice one. Now on camera, it's coming out a bit more yellow. In real life, it's got maybe more of a slightly reddish undertone to it. I completely forgot that, yeah, with this particular concealer, you need to work really fast to blend it out because it dries down quite quickly, just like the foundation. Oh Lord, which I completely forgot about. Now, what I'm finding is that on top of the foundation, it's actually quite difficult to blend. I think because they're both quite, they both dry down quite quickly. I think with this particular concealer and foundation, you probably would be better off using a damp sponge. But I haven't dampened my sponge, so I'm using the brush today. But I think that probably would be best for application because it is quite difficult to blend on top of each other, which is quite strange seeing as they are from the same line. But yeah, that's what I'm finding. I'm going to use my Huda Beauty powder in the shade Cinnamon Bun because I find that this is quite drying, this foundation and concealer base. So I don't want anything that's going to be too drying for a powder. And Huda Beauty's one isn't as drying as like my Laura Mercier, so I think I can just get away with using Huda Beauty's one today. So I've powdered my face. It all looks really nice. The powder went on it quite nicely. It kind of smoothed it out quite a bit. Yeah, definitely not tacky again now with the powder on, but I think my base looks quite nice. So now I'm going to finish off the rest of my face. One thing I did want to note is that my eye has started slightly watering, and it does this when it's quite sensitive to maybe strong scents, and it started watering before I put the Huda Beauty powder on. So I'm thinking it might be the foundation because of the strong chemical scent that it has. I don't know, but this eye all of a sudden just starts watering for some reason now, and I think that's why. So we shall see how well it lasts throughout the day. Okay, so I have now completed my face. Just to quickly run down what I actually used. I obviously used the foundation and concealer from Barry M, as you already saw. But to finish off the rest of my face, I used my Huda Beauty baking powder in the shade Cinnamon Bun. On top of that, I actually used a new bronzer. Yes, guys, you'll be so excited that I did not use my Fashion Fair bronzer today, but I actually did use a new bronzer, which is from MUA. And you can kind of see I didn't put on any blusher, so this bronzer is kind of working as a blusher for me. But I'll give it more of a go. And then on my eyes, I am using the Emily Noel palette, which I have done a full review on, so I'll link that in this video for you. So I'm using this particular palette, and then for my highlighter, I'm using my Maybelline Chrome highlighter in Molten Bronze. And on my lips, I am using a combination of the Revolution Lip Liner in Glory, and I just filled my lips in with that. And then on top, I put a bit of the, what's this, new colour in the Superstay Matte Ink Liquid Lipstick in the shade Globe Trotter. So I love it. It's like that burnt orange kind of colour. So that's what's on my lips today. Really like this look. Hopefully the foundation and concealer will withstand. My eye has been watering slightly, so we're going to excuse that in this review. But apart from that, everything else seems to have gone on quite well, quite nicely. So far, the foundation is lasting. Still feels quite nice, still feels matte. I did set my face as well, sorry, with a setting spray. So yeah, I don't know. It looks good. Everything applied well on top. The only issue I had with application was when I used the concealer on top of the foundation. And I think that's because I just left the concealer to dry down a bit too much. And also, I think it'll probably be best applied with a makeup of the beauty sponge as well. The time now is 11:45. I will check in with you guys around, let's say, 6 o'clock, I think, this evening, just to show you what it's like with me wearing it for 6 hours or so. And yeah, we can see how it lasts. But I have actually tried this foundation on for much longer than that, so I already have my thoughts on it. But just so you guys can see a check-in, I will do so around 6 o'clock, and yeah, we can kind of wrap up this review. So I will see you guys in a few hours, but for you in a few seconds. Hi guys, I'm going to do a very quick update on this foundation. I was going to do it again later on this evening, however I need to pop out so I won't be able to do it. But you can see I've now had the foundation on. I don't have my phone on me, but it's about 6 o'clock right now. So I've had the foundation on for just over 6 hours now, and you can see it's looking quite nice on me. If I look a bit closer, I am definitely getting quite oily in my T-zone area, which is quite normal for me with foundations that don't tend to typically last that well on me. But this isn't the worst performing foundation that I have tried, if I'm being completely honest. Like, it still looks quite good. I think I can definitely make it look better if I just powder my face, but without powdering, this is after 6 hours of wear. This is supposed to be a long, all night long, so a long wearing foundation. They don't necessarily put how many hours, but they say that you should be covered until the early hours, so I'm assuming they mean very, very long hours. Personally, I know that I can't get away with wearing this all day, because I have tried this foundation before, and by the 10th hour I am a greasy mess if I don't put on my powder over it again. So do touch-ups, I'm definitely a greasy mess. But I'm going to quickly do a touch-up for you, and you can kind of see how the powder looks once I have touched up slightly. So you can see touching up has definitely helped. Around my nose area, I'm looking, it's just maybe starting to slightly melt away from my nose, just around like this part. For me, it hasn't really sunk too badly into my fine lines, but slightly in my fine lines around here on my face. Apart from that, everything still looks really, really decent on my face. So I am very happy with this foundation. Now, is it my most favorite foundation in the drugstore? Definitely not. But I think it's a decent foundation. Definitely if you are using it only for a few hours, I'd say, even though it says all night long, I personally wouldn't wear this foundation for too long because of my oily combination skin. But I think it definitely looks really good if you are going to do your touch-ups throughout the night or throughout the day, then I think you can get away with it. So yeah, I really like it. Now, in terms of the concealer, the concealer has definitely lasted. It did sink into some fine lines under my eyes, so just bear that in mind that it can do that. But it's definitely lasted on my skin. It's not melting away or anything, but the major issue is the fine lines, like settling into fine lines under my eyes. That's the main problem with this particular concealer from Barry M. So yeah, apart from that, I do quite like it. It has lasted. Both of them together, as I said, slightly difficult to work with together because they're more drying formula, but I think they would probably work best with a sponge as opposed to a brush because they dry down quite quickly. Let me know what you think about this concealer, foundation, Let me know, have you tried it out yourself? Will you be trying it out? Anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you very soon in my next video. Take care. Bye.